Previously on Project Zomboid. That maybe I didn't install the maps correctly. Okay, so this is Dreadwood, guys. Now the zombies probably aren't going to be too bad right now because this part of the map has just been loaded in, so I would like to find this mansion, this walled-off mansion, though. I think that would be the best place to set up in. I'm not really sure where it is, though. It's on this highway. We're going to take a look up here. I think, yep, this is the place I saw on the map. So yeah, let's take a run around in here. It's even, yeah, it's got like a catwalk up top of the walls, too. This is kind of like, almost like our setup at the farm. Let's just hop back into the back corner here where no one can see us from the street. We'll set up our water tower, all those kind of things back here, I think. That should be all the big stuff. Carpenter's bench, we can put that in the garage. Let's see what's in the neighborhood here. Could be some big groups of zombies on the highway here, so we should be careful. Yeah, there's a fair number of zombies. No ridiculous big groups yet, but they'll gather together. Hello everyone, my name is Nomis, and welcome back to another episode of Project Zomboid. We are picking up here shortly after where we last left off. And my goodness, guys, it has been a crazy start to my day. I had a couple scares with the project. Is it, like, super overgrown in here? Anyway, I've had a super crazy start to my day with Project Zomboid. Started off by me loading back into the game and getting some unexpected errors that would not allow me to open our save file. So I was panicking, thinking that, oh no, has build 33 broken our game? But I seem to have figured it out. I'm not really sure what worked. I verified the game cache integrity. Didn't find anything wrong, but anyway, seems to be working now. We are going to go head outside and take a look at some stuff here, because I don't know, everything looks a lot more overgrown. There was another update. We're up to 33.4 on the IW Bums branch. Everything still seems to be here. Is it just me? Or, like, are the walls, like, a lot more cracked and viney? Alright, anyway. Before we get too far into things today, I just want to address our larger items here that we brought over from the farm. I had some comments, and I do realize that it was maybe a little bit cheaty to bring these big items with us in the wagon, because realistically, you wouldn't be able to fit this stuff. You wouldn't be able to fit a big old water pump into a wagon. You wouldn't be able to bring a mine hole anywhere. And probably the blast furnace too, it would have been too big. Maybe even the stamp mill. So I'm going to leave it up to you guys. I'm alright with stashing these things away and rebuilding them. It seems a little bit silly since we have them here already. But if you guys think it'd be better for us to play it a little bit more realistic and rebuild those things, I'm fine with that. I'll put a straw poll up in the description. Go check that out. Cast your vote. If you guys are fine with just keeping it and continue on rolling in our survival, then we'll do that. But, oh yeah, other big news. This is probably the biggest news for the channel. We just hit 1,000 subscribers this morning. So yeah, that was the other bit of the crazy part of my start to the day. So thank you very much, guys. I'm going to have a dedicated video for that up shortly. But yeah, that's insane. 1,000 people have decided to subscribe to the channel. That's so cool. So thank you very much for that, guys. I'm going to do my best to continue to put out some entertaining content for you in the weeks, months, and who knows, maybe even years ahead. But right now, our main goal, as you can see, I've already started cutting down some trees and getting some planks here, is going to be barricading up that front entrance. That's our main goal for today. That's what we'll be working on. One interesting thing about these trees, like, they look like they're full grown, right? And a full grown tree should take 4 swings of the axe when you have the lumberjack occupation, which we do have. But all these trees come down with two strikes and only give you one log. So, I don't know. I thought that was kind of interesting. Something to do with the Dreadwood map. And somehow those zombies heard us all the way over there. So let's get our combat knife out here. Take care of these stragglers. And it seems like the sound effects have been fixed finally now in 33.4. At least that is, those are the rumors on the message boards. So we'll see throughout this episode if we continue to hear zombies and get all the awesome sound effects that we know and love. Alright. I should probably take care of this guy first. Boom. We'll also be if we can barricade this entrance up here today, we'll also be taking a look at some alternate base locations in town. As you guys have mentioned, and you're probably right. Oh god, that was loud. Might be in our best interest to set up a base above ground, just so we don't even have to worry about zombies breaking in. So there was that one, like, four-story apartment building that we saw when we first entered the map. I'd like to take a look at that place. Alright, I just hope that... Okay, so it's drawing them south, it looks like. We should be alright. There might be a few zombies coming through the woods here. But here they come. We'll take care of a few of these, and then we're gonna hop back into our yard, continue cutting down some trees, getting some planks ready. Oh man, guys, I was so worried this morning when it wouldn't load up. I tried like four times, and I backed up like everything. I backed up like the entire Zomboid game. It's like, oh no, I don't want to lose this. But luckily, it seems to have sorted itself out. Okay. Our combat knife is, looks like it's under 50% now. Don't hear any more rustling. So I think we're good to, head back in here. Let's see here. We're a little bit overweight, though, so we should probably pack some of this stuff away that we're carrying. Like our pistol. These sheet ropes. I put some sheet rope accesses on the second floor. None on this side, apparently. You can see kind of one on the back window up there. And there's one on this side of the house, too. And you can see that there are kind of zombie bodies littered all around from me killing zombies in between episodes. Securing our new home. Alright, so let's keep chopping trees here. So it looks like there's a lot of wood to be had here, but if each tree is only going to give us one log, it's really not that much. We'll have enough to wall off the entrance, but I was expecting there to be a lot more lumber in here. So we'll have to see if all the trees on the map in this area are going to be like this. Come on, hit that. It shouldn't be that big of a deal. Alright, cut down tree. Cut down tree. It is going to be nice having all the sound effects and music back now, though. Okay, no zombies coming. We are still in good shape. Also noticed, similar to, I believe it was the Bedford Falls map, you can't remove any of this grass. So, we could be losing track of a few items in our lawn if we're not careful. Let's saw up these logs. Saw up those. Saw that. And then we should make some rope and bundle these up. Like, yeah, it's hard to see where these logs are in the grass. Come on, where is it? There it is. That one, those two, set that up, okay, that's good. Let's strip some of these zombies down, make some sheet ropes. Craft these into actual rope. Okay. And might as well just grab all these bodies too. Alright, let's see how many ropes can we make now. Make 6 rope. Alright, that's enough. Hello, Mr. Zombie. Better this stuff is, or this area is sealed off, or the sooner it's sealed off, the better. Okay, so let's make a lumber stack out of this. Good. Just drop that on the ground up here. Remember that it's there, because I can't see it anymore. Saw that up. Saw that up. See, there's a couple that we missed already. Pick those up. Twigs. Saw that up. Make another stack. Okay, drop that one. Hopefully we get this finished quickly. So I know this isn't the most exciting for you guys to watch, especially given all the excitement we've had in the last couple episodes. But it must be done. Alright, let's eat this jar of honey. Let's see, what do we got for nails? We only have 5 nails on us. I'll have to go into the garage and pick up some more. Just throw these into our pack dog. Good. We are quite exhausted. Starting to get drowsy. Are there people inside here? No, I don't think so. Thought I heard a thump. Oh, but there is a person there. They just continue to wander in. Off the street. There comes another one. Oh, there's someone up here. Oh, there are people up here. I did hear a thump. Alright, let's get the knife back out. You can actually hear, like, their footsteps. I think that's new in the FMod system. We couldn't hear their footsteps before, could we? Like in build 32? I don't think so. Alright, let's hop in here. Pick up nails. I've pretty much organized everything now. I'll just go ahead and open that up. So we've got kind of our adhesives, nails, lighters in this shelf. We've got kind of odds and ends. I guess I got lighters over there too. Our carpenter bench over here. Some metal items. I could take these batteries, so I'm putting them somewhere else. We got fishing gear in this cabinet here. That shelf is empty. That's empty. That'll probably be for clay and stuff. We've got all our smelting tools in there, along with our blowpipe. Some more crafting materials, more tools in this cupboard. Our guns and ammunition in these two cupboards. So pretty good. Move the apple tree out there. Kitchen is all organized. We're gonna sleep and then we'll work on this fence in the morning. Got magazines and books on this shelf. Got our field guides over here, so easy access for us to go foraging. Bathroom's all been organized. We got all our other skill books on these two bookshelves here. So pretty much all of our books that have recipes are on this shelf. And there were, look at all these, like we didn't bring that many books with us, but like there's a ton of books in this house. So we have all these books pretty much just from this house. All the base game skill books here. And then even more Hydrocraft books. These ones are like without recipes. But yeah, we did pretty good. Got combat weapons in here, so blades, blunt weapons. Let's head upstairs to sleep. We sleep in the billiards room. For this is the safest room. Here's one of those sheetrope accesses. Alright, let's sleep here. Alright, we should be good to start this wall now. We've got three stacks. Each stack has 12 planks. Each wall section will take 3 planks. So, what's that? 4, 8, 12 wall sections. That should be enough to cover that front driveway. Oh, yeah. I don't even think we'll need 12. But we'll have to clear out these few zombies here first, because I'm pretty sure they'll hear us. I would think, anyway. Come here, ma'am. Bam. Lots of nice nature sounds out here. Right on. Oh, painkillers. I will take those. Okay, we should be good to go here. So let's unpack. Oh, is there one more? Yeah. Alright, there we go. Let's unpack this stack. Boom. Build our wall. I'm not gonna put a door on here. We'll just put like a stairway up to the catwalk and then just sheet ropes over the top. Excellent. Ah, we might use them all the planks. I think we'll have a few left over. Alright, let's unpack one of these. Let her walk across. Go. Unpack that. No one's sneaking up behind us. Oh, this is so much quicker than doing our huge wall over at the farm. I don't know if I'll ever take on a wall of that size again. That may have just been a one-off. That was a lot of time. And then to see it all come down so easily. That kind of sucked. Alright, quick primary. Ladies, one at a time, ladies. Alright, we almost got this. It's just another about five, you think? Four or five. And you guys have also left a lot of good suggestions for additional defensive options that we can use, like putting crates out in a kind of a checkerboard pattern, placing fence posts down, just kind of things for zombies to get caught up on rather than them coming after our walls directly. So we will implement some of those tactics as well on this base. But there we go. We at least now have a secure base. Do we have enough to build a staircase? No, we don't. We need a couple more planks. Okay, let's get a couple more planks. We're going to make a staircase up to the top of this wall. We might need a few more planks, actually. So we'll want to make a fence panel so we can plop some sheet ropes over the top. And then we'll do a once through the compound to make sure that no one else is hiding in a corner or something. I think this should work though, the space. Alright, so let's see here. Build stairs, rotate them. I guess we'll just put them like right there, eh? Or we could put it like right on the edge here. There we go, let's do that. And we've got a barbecue out here too, which is nice. Barbecue info. Fuel 20 hours. So can we refuel this? Remove propane tank. Okay, so it takes a propane tank. Interesting. So yeah, if we start collecting propane tanks, that's a good cooking source. Save us from having to worry about campfires. Okay, so do you think this is safe to walk on, guys? Let's see. Oh, moment of truth. Okay, it worked. We're good. Okay, so I'm just going to put... let's go build... fence, wooden fence. Put the fence panel there. And one right there. And I'll add a sheet rope there. Add a sheet rope there. Perfect, so now we can get in and out of the base. In between episodes, I'll start working on putting fences all around there. But that's good for now. Let's put that axe away. Might as well clean up this rag. Oh, we're out of water. Okay, let's go get some more water. Drop that plank for a second. We should probably board up windows too. But it should be pretty safe in here for now. We'll just do a quick run through here, make sure there's no zombies hanging around. Looks like we're good though. Okay. I am satisfied. I'm satisfied that we are safe here. Alright, let's remove some of this broken glass. Alright. Let's see here. I'll just show you this other storage room, what we've got in here. Toys, keep it on this shelf for now. This is the main storage room. We've got clothes, storage containers. We've got batteries in here, so I can actually drop off these two batteries as well. So batteries in there. This other one will be for dead batteries once we start going through some. We've got all our electronics in here. Since we are here, let's dismantle a few things, get some more electronics XP, and we can actually upgrade our first aid to level 1. That's pretty cool. So where's our electrical skill? Oh, a whopping 11.65 now. We're gonna keep our digital watch. We'll dismantle. Oh, can't we dismantle those? Thought we could. We can dismantle the toaster. We can dismantle that vacuum. Apparently not the other vacuum cleaner though. All right, so let's put that in there. Oh, we're almost up to 13 XP there. Another 4 years and we'll have level 1. And then this cupboard here, I've got our sheets, pillows, and then kind of random objects that don't really have a use for us. Okay, so let's get some food in us, refill our water. Close that door, there we go. So we'll go to the kitchen, get some food. Put this stuff away. Anything else I need to drop off? Painkillers can go in there. Okay, that looks good. Alright, so let's grab some food here. We've got, let's see, jarred food in here. We've got canned food and the one next to it. Other non-perishables over here. I think we'll just eat an MRE and we'll take a few donuts with us. We have a couple. Take those two with us, and the taffy, sure. Okay, we've got, let's see, cooking materials in there. Let's see, we've got more cooking items and kitchen-related items in there. We've got all our drinks in the fridge. Or our drinks in the... the cupboard, and then popsicles in the fridge. We've got cooking pot and trays over here. Rotten food over here, so that's for planting and more potted plants, so yeah. Things are looking good in the base. Go get some water. Actually, we could just fill up water here, hey? And just use the toilet. Clean that up. You can hear the dripping water. That's cool. And some of these doors are tricky to open. We've got a few hours in the day left. So let's head out. Do a little bit of looting. Still got quite a bit of stuff in my backpack, but I'll drop that off later. Alright, let's climb over here. Let's see if we can take a look at that apartment type building. Well, we got several zombies in the woods there. I think it was just down here, wasn't it? Yeah, there it is, right there. That might be a good base. So we're gonna have to kill these zombies. It's gotta be done. Population isn't too bad right now. It'll probably increase in the coming days as they group more and more together. Fall back a bit. I like the sound effects of them walking, or footsteps. It's a cool addition. Alright, before we check out the tower, let's check out this cabin here. Cabin that's apparently full of zombies. Back off. Oh, get out of here. Man, I've had a few of those, hey, recently. Where I kind of missed the stab. Alright, who else is in here? Lots of broken windows. Alright, no one else. Nothing in there. Locked, nothing in there. Although it looks very full. Push broom. Not much. Some boxers. Alright. This is kind of odd. There's hardly any gear in here. Let's get out our axe. It's like we already went in that one. Whoops. Another skill point. Nothing in there. A hard hat. Really? Okay, gummy bears. Can we take this, I want to take that deer head. Can I not take that? I don't think so. No, apparently I can't. That would have been cool. There's this room here. Some random books. Let's tear off the cover on this one. See what that gives us. Check textbook. Don't need that. A satchel. Alright, just want to try this again. Nope. Okay. Alright. Oh, where's the door? Alright, we might want to head home, sleep for the night, and then check out the tower in the morning. They probably saw us, hey? Did they? No, they didn't. Let's get back home. Hop up here. We just gotta be careful not to break our leg. Going along that catwalk. So I'm gonna go to bed here, and we'll pick up again in the morning, and we'll finish off the episode by checking out that tower. So bright and early the next morning. Let's hop over the wall again. The next stage will be us putting the log spike barriers down in front of that wall. Or I guess the log wall first and then log spike barriers. And we'll probably put concrete pillars on the inside. And then we'll put... we could probably just fill up this whole driveway with crates and fence posts. stuff for the zombies to focus on instead of the wall. But let's get down to this tower. Check this out. They hear us? I think one of them heard us. So how many levels is this? One, two... I think it's like five. Right, there must be a front door. Family Fashions. Oh, that's kind of got a nice roof on it too. Some place like this would have a lot of space. Oh nice, it's open. A lot of space for storage, which is always nice. So 9mm rounds. Our pillow. We'll take for the feathers so we can make more arrows. We need to start stockpiling some medical supplies because we never ended up bringing that much down with us. All we have as far as medical supplies is what's in this medical box. So it looks like a little bit of everything, but I don't see any beta blockers in there, so we are going to want to keep our eye out for some more beta blockers. Or if you can just find a pharmacy, that'd be probably best. Let's take the stuff. Pickles, ketchup, ice cream, water bottle. Watermelon we'll take for planting. Ooh, a V3 remote controller. Very nice. Whiskey bottle. We have the, we know the recipe. Oh, look at that in here. There's a meat patty in there. A fresh cooked meat patty. Oh my god. Let's take that. We know the recipe for the V1 remote controller. So we're gonna have to look into the recipes for the traps. Cause those would be quite handy to make a few of those. Baseball bats, more earplug or earbuds, we can dismantle those right now. Get the XP. So what do you guys think? Should we set up in here as well? Maybe make this like an outpost, a safe house. It's pretty close to our base, but I guess it could be somewhere to fall back to. I'll take the empty pillbox. Let's fill up our water bottles. Ooh, a dog whistle. You guys reminded me as well that we left about half of our dogs behind, so let's go ahead and search for a stray dog right now. A Labrador. There we go. We got a new companion. Let's take the gloves. Yeah. Take a dog bowl for our dogs now. Another welding gas tank. Good. Up to the next floor. Floor number 3. Okay, that's locked. Let's get our axe out. Some sparklers. Okay, that's good. Might as well take the twine too, I guess. Barbecue sauce, okay. The barbecue sauce, I think we can use that to make a marinade for making jerky. That's good to have. I'll leave that stuff there. What else we got in here? Toilet cleaner, I don't think we need that stuff. Looks like another storage room. Some more nails. Some steel pipe. Not sure if we need steel pipe or anything anymore. We do need some welding hose though, because I remembered, or I realized that we didn't bring our welding unit. We just brought the tank. So we'll have to find another welding mask too. Recraft that. Shoehorn. Here's our first balcony. Very cool. Yeah, ooh. Look at that building. Ooh, that's nice too. They got some nice buildings here in Dreadwood. All right, let's head up to the next floor. No zombies in here, which is kind of surprising. A pipe, okay. Oh, look at all this electronics gear. Oh, we got the generator magazine too. Nice. All right, let's read that. So we can use a generator now. That's awesome. A V2 remote controller. Wow. I was just saying to someone in the comments in one of the previous videos that I hardly ever find electronic gear. So it's kind of crazy that we're finding so much right now. We'll come back for that stuff. Another dog whistle. Okay, let's look for another stray dog. We got a Labrador, and we've got two Labradors, two male Labradors. All right. Brothers. Labrador brothers. Some fish food. Hammer and nail gun ammo, we'll take that. Wow, two dog whistles. That's crazy. Just a balcony, hey? Balcony with a view, though. Oh, and there's the gas station right there. Ooh. Awesome. Okay. We just need to find another generator now. What the hell is that? Alarm clock? That's a very choppy scream. Did you guys hear that? Adhesive bandage, we'll take that. Hairspray, we'll take the bleach. Hand soap, we'll take. So I think we can use that to wash towels, right? Razor blade, we should take. I think I saw another razor blade down there. I should probably pick that up. So I think we can make like razor blade gloves. That'd be a cool weapon to try out. All right, so what do we got here? Let's go up another flight. This must be the top. Oh, and a steak in here. No, I'm gonna eat this whole steak right now. Delicious. Wolf that whole thing down. Very well fed. Some pickled herring. A white pumpkin. Okay, we can plant this in a potted plant. Some seeds. Okay, good. We should start collecting seeds because we didn't bring any with us. Oh! A meat cleaver. We finally found a meat cleaver. Oh, this has been a good looting session. A good day to loot. What a maze of rooms. More hairspray, a bath sponge, I'll take that. Vitamins. Take the soap. Can we break this down? Yes, we can. Dismantle that. Alright, very cool. Oh, there's still one more floor. Up to the roof, I guess. And another stake. Aluminum, another V3 remote controller. A motion sensor, an amplifier. Oh my god. Look at all this electronic gear. And the Bacon, yeah, we'll take that to for the XP. Pickled tomatoes, I'll come back for that. Wow, I can't believe we found so much electronic gear today. Let's see here. How do we get into this room? Is there a door here? How do we get in there? I don't see a door. Huh? I'm confused. I don't see any door here. Alright, we're gonna have to smash that open, I guess. Alright, well, I guess we will end this episode here then. Unless I can get through here. Last room to check. More razor blades. Vitamins. Okay, so I'm gonna have to go back for our sledgehammer because I don't think I have it on us. No, well, we'll go back for the sledgehammer. But that'll be it for today, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Leave me some comments below regarding the big items, big craftable items like the blast furnace, mine, water pump. Are you guys okay with us keeping those? Do you want us to recraft them? Since it doesn't really make sense that we would be able to bring them with us in the wagon when we came down here. Let me know about that. Let me know about this building. Do you think we should set up a base? Like another safe house here. I think it would be a cool building to use. We got some gunfire there that's drawing people, a lot of people south. So yeah, we're gonna end things here. We'll pick up next episode, do a little bit more scouting around Dreadwood, do some more looting, and yeah, I guess do a little bit more work on the defenses of our main base. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. Until next time, I'll talk to you all later.